Hello everyone, how is it going? In this tutorial, we are going to create a liquid melt text effect in GIMP. Let's dive into it. Alright, first, let's make a new canvas in here by going to File, New, and I set to this 1:1 ratio, just hit OK. And open the texture in File, open its layer, and adjust this. Scale it down by pressing Shift S, and hold Ctrl Shift while scaling. And press enter. Next, create a text with text tool, press T and type. Change the text color to. Change the size to. And change the font to. Rec. Can place it in the middle. Next, we're going to create a perspective with perspective tool. You can go to here. Or the shortcut is Shift P. Click on the text, and you can hold Shift to lock this corner and this too. Press Enter to apply. Next, we're going to create a reflection. You can duplicate the layer, click this icon, and press Shift F to flip and click. With Move tool, click this icon and just move it down. You can hold Shift to make it snap. Scale it to the bottom, press Shift S. And without holding Ctrl Shift, just drag it down. And this, make it up. And press Enter. Now we're going to bring the texture for making this liquid text effect in Vol. Open this layer and adjust this. Shift convert. And we can scale it down by pressing Shift S. Hold Ctrl Shift while scaling. Let's make it proportional scale. Run this. Move it down a little and press enter. On the reflection text, you can right click, all part to selection. While in selection, go to this foil layer, right click, add layer mask, and choose this selection. So it will follow the selection path. Deselect it and select and choose none. And just delete this old reflection. And apply the layer mask by right click, choose apply layer mask. Double click to rename it. And place it below this original text. Now the fun thing begin. We're going to give the color to this liquid effect. Go to gradient tool, click this icon. Or the shortcut is G. And let's change this gradient to adjust this full saturation spectrum. Make sure you click this liquid effect layer and go to color, map, and choose this gradient map. Now we're using the smudge tool to create the liquid effect. Click this icon or the shortcut is S. You can turn down the spacing to 1. Just brush it down like this. We'll create melt text effect. Just one little tip, you see these yellow boundaries? If I brush through it, it will not go through it. So, what you do is right click, layer to image size. So it will make the layer same width as the canvas. Okay, let's see. And continue to brush it. You can try to reduce the force to get a different result. And the size. Okay, now do the same like the original text, but first I'm going to duplicate it with make it only stroke. So click this duplicate icon. With move tool, you can bring it to up by holding Ctrl Shift. And on this layer, right click, all part to selection. While in selection, go to select and choose shrink. Just make it by 1 and press delete on the keyboard. And don't forget to deselect in select and choose none. and scale it down by pressing Shift S, hold Ctrl Shift while scaling to make it proportional scale. Place it on here. Add one more, so just going to duplicate this. With Move tool, just bring it to up. And scale it down by pressing Shift S, then hold Ctrl Shift while scaling. On here. Press Enter. Now this time we're going to use the Smart tool, press S on the keyboard, or click this icon. And on the original text, and you don't want to get this result, so the solution is right click, just layer to image size, and just brush it down. And you can also increase the force for easier to blend it. We can also use the warp tool, click this, and try to increase the size around here. And you can choose the option if you want to move the pixel, grow area, shrine, and many more here. Let's try with move pixel first. In this liquid effect layer, okay, I just turn down the strength just a little. And try with this. Make it clean. With eraser tool, you can erase this certain part. Click this icon, or the shortcut is Shift E. And on this liquid effect, just erase it. Also, you can have fun with the color in this liquid effect layer and go to color, hue and saturation. And I try to make this all the way up. And let's change the hue. I love this one, then hit OK. And we can try more with the color temperature. You can go to colors, color temperature, and just turn it down a little. Alright, all of this galaxy color, just hit OK. Love it! Now we're going to create the glow effect. You can duplicate this liquid effect layer and change the layer mode to heart-like. And make it blur, you can go to filter, blur, and choose this Gaussian blur. Turn it up. And hit OK. And move down the layer to here. And you can reduce the opacity. Before we're done, let's create a noise effect by going to filter, noise, and choose this EHV noise. You can try to increase the dulling and the hue. Try with saturation too. And the value around this. Hit OK. And for this original text, you can go to filter, noise, and choose this EHV noise. Now the last thing, I'm going to add the text element by pressing T and type, change the color to, change the font to, change the size to, place it on here. You can activate the gauge by dragging it like this, and you can add more, and on here just drag it down. Right, just going to duplicate this rename it to and just add more text by duplicating it. Place it on here and change it to, you can add more by duplicating this text and with move tool and type, you can adjust the letter spacing in this, make it by 5, size 2, and you can rotate it by pressing shift R and hold control shift to make it 15 degree increment, then click and place it on here. Just add one more text. You can hide the guides in view and unhide this, or the shortcut is shift control T. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. You can try with new gradient color and do some experiment with the perspective to make it more amazing result. I'm ZK from ZK Design, create something good today. Thanks for watching.